Now, what's also making news is the likelihood of both Rahul Gandhi and Priyanka Vadra visiting Ayodhya before filing their nominations if they are fielded. Times Now has learned through sources that the Gandhi siblings may visit the Ram Mandir and offer prayers there. This, meanwhile, has triggered another big political face-off, with the BJP gunning for Rahul and the Congress party calling them Chunavi Hindus, and not for the first time. But now, the top seers of Ayodhya, including the Ram Mandir Trust's head, Nritya Gopal Das, and the Hanumangadi temple priest Mahant Raju Das, have also slammed Rahul Gandhi. They say no matter how many darshans Rahul Gandhi takes, God will never forgive him.
Darshan karte rahe, sab kuch hai, lekin Bhagwan ko chhama nahi karenge. Wo desh ka aparadhi hai, rashtra ka virodhi vyakti hai. Wo to janta bata degi. Jis tarah se uske purvajon ne rashtra ko chhala hai, thaga hai, badmaash, aaj dekhiye. वीर सावरकर को गालियां देते फिर रहा है, शर्म नहीं उसको आती है।
राहुल जी और प्रियंका जी का अयोध्या आने का तय हो रहा है। हिंदुओं से अपील है कि कोई दिक्कत नहीं है, अयोध्या ये स्वागत है, लेकिन अभी आपको भगवान श्री कृष्ण की जन्मभूमि जाने की जरूरत है। अयोध्या में निमंत्रण आपको दिया जा रहा था, आए नहीं, इसके पहले भी आप नहीं आए। भगवान राम को इतने वर्षों तक टेंट में रखा, काल्पनिक कहा, वाकई में हिंदुओं से आपको प्रेम है, वाकई में आपके सनातन के प्रति इतनी निष्ठा है, तो आप तत्काल भगवान श्री कृष्ण की जन्मभूमि आइए और वहां जल उठाइए, संकल्प लीजिए, भव्य भगवान श्री कृष्ण की जन्मभूमि मंदिर निर्माण राहुल गांधी करेगा, नहीं तो समझ जाएगा कि आप कालेमी है, शुद्ध रूप से वोट की राजनीति करते हैं और कुछ नहीं।
Union Minister Piyush Goyal once again also reacted to the buzz over Rahul and Priyanka possibly visiting Ayodhya, taking a swipe at Rahul in particular. He said the Congress leader should go to the Ram Mandir and apologize for his mistakes of insulting Lord Ram and denying his existence.
Ram Mandir mein avashya jana chahiye. Ye alag baat hai ki unhone duniya bhar ke naam ka maan kiya hai. Ye alag baat hai ki unhone to Ram ke astitv ko hi challenge kiya. ये अलग बात है कि वो चुनाव आते हैं तो उनको शिव जी भी याद आते हैं, महादेव भी याद आते हैं और प्रभु श्री राम भी याद आते हैं। अवश्य उन्होंने राम मंदिर जाना चाहिए, प्रभु श्री राम के दर्शन लेने चाहिए और अपने जो उन्होंने गलतियां की हैं, जिस प्रकार का भ्रष्टाचार उनकी कांग्रेस पार्टी ने बार बार किया है, उसके लिए अवश्य प्रभु श्री राम से उन्होंने क्षमा भी मांगी।
So this is an interesting subplot, and Adeep joins us once again. Adeep, if Rahul and Priyanka are fielded, one or both of them, will they go to Ayodhya? And if they go to Ayodhya, what face will they present to the people? Because thus far, the BJP has backed them into a corner, hasn't it, over Ayodhya? They skipped the Pran Pratishtha.
Well, definitely the top leadership of Congress may have skipped the Pran Pratishtha event, including the leadership of the Uttar Pradesh Congress. But we remember how the Uttar Pradesh Congress committee, including the state president Ajay Rai, along with the Congress officials, went to Ayodhya before Pran Pratishtha. They offered their prayers and they said that we are not going into the event of BJP. They said that this is a BJP's event. We will not be going into the BJP event, but we will go whenever we will decide and whenever God will call us. This is what the Uttar Pradesh Congress has to say. As far as Rahul Gandhi and Priyanka Gandhi are concerned, sources are suggesting that before entering into the politics of Uttar Pradesh, the duos may go to the Ram temple to offer prayers. BJP, including the Prime Minister Modi and the top leadership of BJP, had been attacking Congress for declining the invitation of Ram Mandir Pran Pratishtha, and they have been cornering the Congress party for declining this event. So now the Congress is trying to make up to that. They are trying to make up what they did the last time. They are trying to amend their mistakes, and this is an aim to target some voters, some vote banks before entering the Hindi heartland of Uttar Pradesh. However, the BJP and the saints in Ayodhya are now also targeting the Gandhi family. The BJP is saying that their Hindutva just comes right when they have to collect the votes of the people of UP.
Absolutely. Adeep, just another quick one. Now, another theory that did the rounds was that Rahul Gandhi has a empty schedule on the 1st of May and the 3rd of May, and this is when he could potentially file his nomination. Is that the window within which they may go to Ayodhya? Is it likely to happen very, very soon? Tell us.
Well, definitely, as per the sources, if Rahul Gandhi has to come to Ayodhya, that will be on the 1st May. He may go to Ayodhya to offer prayers, and on 3rd May, he may come to Amethi to file his nomination. Remember, the last day to file the nominations for the 5th phase of elections is on May 3rd. So we are expecting that whoever from the Congress party's candidate will be coming on the May 3rd or on the May 1st to file his nomination. Smriti Irani, who's the incumbent MP of Amethi, she'll be filing her nominations tomorrow. But as far as Congress is concerned, we are expecting that Congress will be filing their nomination on the May 1st or May 3rd in Amethi and Raebareli.
All right. I thank Adeep once again for sharing these details. So it's a big day, at least in terms of the Amethi battle. Smriti Irani will at least be filing her nomination. It remains to be seen who she'll be contesting against. Viewers, this looks like it's going down to the wire. Even the announcement for the Gandhi siblings is expected perhaps late, but eventually we are tracking this, as you know, very closely.
Kane sir, your dinner.
On a tile? Arre, it's antibacterial.
Scratch resistant also.
But plates?
Kane bhai, it's a tile lad.
IM Plus technology se bane world class tiles. Tile ho to simple ho.